Good morning, student. Dear student, in your previous class, we had solved at the question number 13 from the exercise 10A. Now, in this class, we will solve some more questions from the exercise 10A. That is, we start from the question number 40. The ratio of length of field is to its width. In the 14th exercise 10A, ratio of length and width, that is 5:3, and its width is, and find the length if the width is, and width 42 meter. Now let the length and width be 5x and 3x. So 3x is equal to 42. It is given. Then the x is equal to 42 upon 3. That is 14. Now length will be, that is 5x, which is equal to 5 × 40. It is 70 meters. Okay. In the question number 15, the ratio of income to saving of a family is 11:2. Find if the expenditure, if the saving is
15,
income and saving, income to saving.
Eleven ratio two. Let the income be 11x and saving 2x, then 2x is equal to, the saving is given as, saving is ₹1520. Then x is equal to 1520 upon 2, that is 760. Now expenditure. That is 11x is the income and 2x is the saving. That is 11x minus 2x, that is 9x, which is equal to
6840. You note it. Okay, now 16, that is same seventy is also same. Now we will solve the question number 18. Question number 18. In the question number 18, a bus covered 128 km in 2 hours and a train covered 240 km in 3 hours. Find the ratio of their speed. Speed of bus per hour, that is 128 in 2 hours, that is 128 upon 2, that is 64 km per hour, and speed of train per hour, that is he covered 240 in 3 hours, that is 240 upon 3, that is 80 km per hour. Now ratio of speed, that will be 64:80, that is 64/80, it is 4:5. Now question number 9, from each of the given pair, find which ratio is larger. To compare two ratios, we will compare them right in the fraction. Which ratio is larger? 3/4, 3:4, or 9:16, that is question number 19. Which ratio is larger? So we write it in the fraction form, 3/4 or 9/16. Now we compare two fractions. We will take the LCM, that is 16. 4 × 16, that is 12, or 9, that is 12/16, and that is n. And 9/16, here 12 is more than 9, so 12/16 is more than 9/16, that is 3:4. 3/4 is more than 9/16, sorry, 9/16, this means 3:4 is more than 9:16. So we will solve that all of the question by this method. We will solve the one question from the question number 20. In the question number 20, fill in the blanks. 24/40 is equal to ball upon 5 is equal to 12/ball. Here we see that this is in form of the fraction. To fill it up, 40 convert into 5. How we 40 convert into 5? It is divided by 8. So we also divide 24 by 8, that is 3. Now 24 convert to 12. It is divided by 2. So 40 also divided by 2, that is 20. In the B,
Third, 5 upon 7 box upon 28, that is 35 upon, here is the box. 5, 7 convert to 28.
How 7 convert to 28? 7 convert to 28, that is multiply by 4.
So we also 4 multiply that, that is 20, and 5 convert to 35, that is multiply by 7. So 7 also convert to multiply by 7, that is 49.
Okay, so your exercise 10A, that is completed. Rest of the question you will solve that. Now we will discuss a new topic, that is proportion. First you note it. Okay, now we come on the next topic, that is proportion. If two ratios are equal, we say that if two ratios are equal, we say that in proportion. We say that in proportion. When two ratios are equal, we say that are in the proportion, and we use to symbol that as well as are equal, as to equate the two equal. Four number in a proportion. Let A, B, C, D are four number. Numbers
C ratio D and or A ratio B as C ratio D. A ratio B as well as C ratio D. Where A and D are called extreme terms and B and C are called mean terms. B and C are called the mean terms, or you can say extreme terms are mean terms. In the proportion product of extremes, is equal to product of means. That is, A into D is equal to B into C. A into D is equal to B into C. Or you can say that first term multiplied with the fourth term, that will be equal to the second term multiplied with the third term. Here, A first term, B second term, C third term, and D that is fourth term of the proportion. So what you say that if two ratio are equal, if A ratio B and C ratio D is two ratio, if they are equal, then A B C D is called in the proportion. In the proportion, A is the first term, B is the second term, C is the third term, and D is the fourth term. Where A, B, C, D are A and D is also called the extreme term, B and C called the mean term. In the proportion, product of extreme is equal to product of mean. Okay, you note it. Okay, now we come on the next topic, that is continuous proportion. See numbers. A, B, A. if A ratio B as B ratio C or B into B equal to A into C or B square equal to A into C, then A, B, C are called continuing proportion
where B is called the mean terms, where B is called the mean terms. Okay, you note it. Now we come on the next exercise, that is exercise 10B. And the first question, determine the following number are in the proportion. First, which is first? Determine the 4, 6, 8, 12. Four numbers are in the proportion when the ratio of first to ratio of 4 and 6, that is 4 upon 6, 2, that is 2 ratio 3, and ratio of 8 and 12. That is 8 upon 12, which is 2 ratio 3. Here, ratio of 4 and 6 and 8 and 12 are same. So, 4, 6, 8, 12 are in proportion. Okay, so there are some more questions are given that you will solve that. Now we come on the question number 2. In the question number 2, verify the following. Here, 16 ratio 105 such as 84 ratio 147 are in the proportion or not. If there are the ratio of 2, that is product of mean that is 105 into 84, 105 is equal to product of extremes, then it verifies, otherwise
not verified.
If the product of mean is equal to product of extreme, then it verify, otherwise it will not verify.
That is product of extreme. Now we find the product of mean. Mean that is 105 into 84. 105 into 84 8 is 20 and product of extreme that is 16 into 147 that is 0 plus 25.
Okay, you can also solve it. You can solve the question number 2 as, otherwise you can solve the question number 2 by this method also. We take the another question 91
ratio 104 such as 119 ratio 136. 91 ratio 104 is equal to 91 upon 104. That is 7 upon 8 and 119 ratio 136 that is 119 upon 136. Did the SCF of this 77 that both are same, show it verified.
You can solve the question number 2 by this method or by this method. Okay, you note it. Okay students, in today's class we have completed the exercise 10 and we also discussed about of the proportion, and we will solve some question from the exercise 10, that is question number 1 and 2. Rest of the question from the question number 1 and 2 you will solve that. Okay, thank you, good day.